G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, what I want to talk about is grade, or how we can calculate and how the slope of the ground is expressed. As you can see here, and as you'd realise, not many building blocks are actually level or flat. They normally have some sort of slope, and quite often we actually might have to build in a slope onto our block, whether it's just to drain off surface water, or whether we're actually digging a trench, which is going to have a pipe in it, and that pipe needs to fall for sewage or stormwater type reasons. We're going to get told what angle or what grade our natural or our prepared ground needs to be at. So there's three ways that that angle is normally given to us. Okay, and the first one's as a ratio. So in this case, we've got a ratio of 1 is 10. So basically that means, in this case, I'm going to work in meters. For every 10 meters that the ground runs, then it actually rises 1 meter. Okay, so you could have a ratio of 1 in 20, 1 in 50, depending on the slope that you're actually required. So in this case, I'm going to go with 1 in 10. That's the first way, so that's a ratio. So to actually work out how far the ground rises for every metre, all you need to do is divide the 1 by the 10, or the rise by the run, and that'll give you an answer of a 0.1 or 100 mil. So for every metre that the ground comes across, or that you come across, you're going to go, the ground's going to rise 100 mil. So therefore, if you times the 0.1 by whatever length you happen to need, you're going to get the actual rise at that point. So if you come 2 metres in, it's going to rise 200 mil. And if you come 3 metres in, it's going to rise 300 mil, and so on. Okay. So the calculation you have to do is just divide the rise by the run to give you this little factor, and then you times that by the length that you need, and that'll give you the actual rise of the ground at that point. Okay, so that's ratio. That's the first method. The second method is a bit like roofing. They just give you an angle. Okay, so in this case, I've picked 5.7 degrees, and you'll see why in a minute. So the angle is this angle down here. Okay, the smaller are the angles in the actual triangle. So 5.7 degrees. So to actually get the rise of that, if you do 10... times the run, so 10 angle will give you the rise per meter. So if you did 10 5.7 106, you'll get 0.1, same as we did for our ratio. And if you then times that by the distance that you need here, then in this case 10, you'll get a meter, so it'll give you the rise. Okay, so we can get it given to us as an angle. And we can also work backwards and work out what our angle is. If we get given a ratio, for example, and we want to work out what the actual angle is, what we can do, and we can do it with this one here, we do our rise divided by run, and then in our calculator we use the inverse tan function, which means you're going to have to hit the shift button in most cases, and then the tan button. Now remembering, if you're using a scientific calculator on your phone, the order of operation could be slightly different. You might have to do shift tan and then do the rise divided by run to get the answer to come out right, but that's the process. So in this case, it'd be 1 meter divided by 10, which we know gives us 0.1. Shift tan or inverse tan, it'll give you the actual angle of that slope, so 5.7106 degrees in this case. Okay, so that's angle, that's two. So we've got ratio, we've got angle, and the last one we can get is a percentage. Okay, in this case, 10%. And all we can, the best thing to do with a percentage is just to convert that back into a ratio. So 10% means that this particular bit of land is going to rise 10 meters for every 100 meters of run. Okay, and if you divide 10 into 100, obviously you're going to get 1 and 10. So we're back to our 1 in 10 ratio. Okay. And again, the way we can do that, if you so if you take the 10, if you take the 100 and times that by 10%, you get a rise of 10 meters, which we did here. And same if you had a run of 10 meters and you times that by 10%, you're going to get a rise of 1 meter, which we know works for this block of land. Okay, so there's the three different ways that grade can be expressed on our plans. And as I said, we can use it to grade the block of land, to drain water, or maybe we've got to dig a trench and put a pipe in for sewage or stormwater or something like that. And we can actually work out how far the ground has to rise or fall for the distance that it travels.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.